When you say it's a beautiful village, what do you expect? Is it a tour to the coffee plantation, or a walk to the rice terrace garden, or standing under a waterfall? Is it art and culture, or just simple, beautiful people? Before we decide, let's visit the place. We are talking about Ubud, the treasure trove of culture, people, heritage, nature, and indeed a prime spot to stay when traveling to Bali. So what we did in Ubud? Hired a cab from our hotel, which was safe and reasonable. Then we roamed around the terrace garden to waterfalls and experienced how the most expensive coffee of Bali is made. So follow us for a few minutes. This upland of Bali is famous for its green and picture-perfect landscape. Terrace rice paddies is one of them. This beautiful landscape and the different shades of green will pamper your eyes. Walking through the rice terrace garden will definitely give you the reason for escaping your own city.
This is the Garden of Rice, most popularly known here as Tegallalang. Whereas Tegal means garden and Lalang means rice. And here, most importantly, is that you know, you see these terrains, they have been divided between the socio-economic status of the villagers. So whoever has the higher status gets the upper land, and the one who has the lower gets the one below. This lovely terrace garden has another unique feature, which is the entire cultivation process is organic, and there is the least use of chemical fertilizers.
Apart from soaking in the beauty of Tegallalang, you can do some adventure sports and of course enjoy the breathtaking swing. After strolling in the rice field, we decided to cut the heat. So our friend Gusti suggested us to visit the nearest rainforest waterfall, Kanto-lampo. Though it is not famous like other waterfalls of Ubud, but we considered it as the best because it was less crowded and more close to nature, and for some people, perfect place for photoshoot. To reach the waterfall, we will have to go down some stairs. Be careful from the slippery steps. You can spot some beautiful fish and few caves where soldiers used to hide their weapons during the World War II. Our next destination is also a waterfall called Tegallalang. It is a famous waterfall in Ubud. To reach the foot of the waterfall from the parking, you will have to walk more. Being a well-known place, it is more crowded. But if you're a shopaholic, you will like this place because there are plenty of shops at the entrance from where you can buy souvenirs and test your bargaining skills. Though we visited a few temples during our Ubud tour, but those we will show in the video focusing on the temples of Bali. Wait, we still have to go to the last destination at Tebasari. We strolled through the coffee plantation and spice garden and learned the entire process of making the world's most expensive coffee called Luwak Coffee. A guide who works at this place took us through the various trees and plants of coffee, coca, bananas, spices like clove, cinnamon, cardamom, turmeric, and many more.
Two kinds of coffee?
Yeah, Arabica and Robusta.
Again, then coffee also becomes red.
Yeah.
Then you pluck it.
Yeah.
Here, we even learned that in Bali, two kinds of coffee are grown, Arabica and Robusta. But the most expensive coffee in Bali is Kopi Luwak, meaning coffee made from beans digested by a Luwak, Balinese name for a civet. Civets or Luwaks are said to eat the best and ripe coffee cherries, and hence the famous Luwak coffee originated in Bali. Here we learn the step-by-step process of preparing the Luwak coffee, starting with: first, the Luwak's digestive coffee beans are collected. Those beans are then dried under the sun. Then they are cracked and peeled. Cleaning process of washing with hot water is step number 4. Then is roasting, grinding and sieving. We also learned that the coffee and coca plucked from the trees also follow the main 6 steps, which start from drying under the sun to roasting, grinding and then finally sieving. After learning the process, you can spend some time sipping away the various kinds of tea, coffee in the cafe. And don't forget to taste their chocolates. You could also click a picture with an owl or a python. Since we were running out of time, we skipped it this time. After the fun-thrilled Ubud tour, we chose Adil Villa and Resort for a comfortable yet a budget-friendly stay. Here, the cherry on the cake for us was the swimming pool overlooking the rice fields.